Type of thing. When we eat, there are two types of variety of things. One is juicy and one is not juicy. When you take the juicy thing, then your thirst will be also, you're satisfied with eating and you're feeling nice. Liquid and food, both is coming. All satisfaction is coming. Full satisfaction is juicy. So Krishna is a full satisfaction giving. So he is juicy. One is a dry, one is a juicy.
Tasteful, right?
What is tasteful? If you eat something dry, you need something juicy also. If there's anything is a juicy, then it's no need dal. Because it's a soup also and sabji also. And like you take the papaya, less juicy. Juicy is there, less juicy. Some fruits are also less juicy and one is full of juice. So juicy, if you take, you satisfy with both your hunger and your
thirst.
Both.
Thirst.
Both is satisfied. Means all your senses want to satisfy, you need juicy. This is rasa. So material world is like a dry. And a spiritual world, where Krishna is there, juice is there. Juice is there. He gives the juice, rasa. And the feeling make you to drink more juicy things. Bhav is a feeling. If you have no feeling, then you don't need juicy. Like one person is only taking roti and sabji dry because some difficulty, material difficulties are there. And one is taking only juicy things because the bhav is there, feelings are there. So he develop feelings, develop bhav, develop juicy. Feelings to be juicy. You see the Italians, they are more juicy than other countries. Why? Nature is juicy. Why juicy become nature? Because they are very close with Jesus also. Saintly persons also come there. So the land becomes juicy with feelings and with rasa. You see, first time he come, he start chanting, coming in morning chanting. This young boy. And yesterday he's telling that I need one deity also. What to do? I don't believe that he can do that. But her boy, girl, Tulsi also, the wife, also liked that. So both are interested for that. So feelings make Tulsi. Is it proud or not? This is proud for the mother and father, that my son-in-law, he don't know anything, and now he's ready to worship Radha Mohan. In the first, why this is happening in his life? Because he has a past life Sukriti. Without past life Sukriti, nobody can do this. Takes 10 years, 20 years, only to understand the God consciousness. And running for only that. Radhe Radhe! How are you? Good? All is good?
All is good.
Yeah. No? This is the beauty of understanding. We are living in Nirasa.
Nirasa.
Our association is only with no feelings. And I'm listening also to those people who has no feeling. Selection, you see? What is my selection? Out of feelings. And living with no feelings person. Dry. What is happening? I becoming dry. Without no feelings, what happened? You are becoming dairy material. You don't see that? How rasa will come in your life? How you will become rasik? What you will teach to others? We become more and more empty with nothing. Because of my faults, he was happy. Like me, preachers also do. Because of my false ego, I am going and preaching that I am a guru and this, that. But no feelings. And we have no one, something is listening. And but I am listening without no feeling. What small feeling we have, we achieve in Vrindavan, we dry up with no feeling persons. Right or not? Understand or not? See? Our juice is gone. To get it, the juice, juicy life is gone. Feeling is not there, more drying is coming. Yeah. Any more questions?
No.
Clear?
Yes, thank you.
So be careful. It's better to go under tree and chant. Leave in your room. lie in your bed and chant, then become disturb yourself. Sit and say to Subha, read something. And listen to him. There is no grihastha and renounced person. Real renouncement person is that who has real attachment, who has the rati. Attachment is rati. Rati. If rati is not there, attachment is not there, association is just for fun. Good time passed. Read.
I was thinking maybe we can read second verse of Shikshashtakam. Last time we were reading first.
As you like.
It's possible.
Mike, give the speaker. Give the smallest speaker.
Maybe we can read the first one also. And then
we will never get to the second one. Read your second one, Muraj. Because otherwise we will never get to the... If we start with the first one, we will never get to the second one. Radhe?
Make it loud.
Yes. Radhe?
More loud.
Radhe? Oh my God, that's really close. So this is second verse of Shikshashtakam, given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It says, O Lord!
In Sanskrit.
Oh. Nam nam akari bahudanicca sarva shaktis tatarpita niyamita smaranena kala etate ishtava kripa bhagavan mamapi durdaivam idisham ichanina anuraga. O Lord, you have given us many names of yours to chant.
Many names. Not confused with the many names. Because you give many names to them. Yeah.
O Lord, you have given us many names of you to chant, investing them with all your transcendental power.
All your name is full of transcendental power. If you have a feeling in that name, that will increase more. If no feeling, nothing happens.
And there are no strict regulations as to when to chant or remember these names.
No regulations. You are sitting in toilet or sleeping on bed. Sitting for bhajan, it's the same. Name has to go on and in non-stop. If you are eating, you are cooking, you are driving the car, you are working, you are on bed, every moment we have to practice that automatic name is happening. That is the meaning of the name. If the feeling will grow, this habit will come. Like if you want to think for someone, you think in bathroom or not? Are you on the bed, you think or not? Are you are driving, you think or not? You are cooking and mind is going there or not? Similarly, name is to be with feeling. When the name will come, this will start happening in our life. That is the important thing. When this will come, then the real feeling is there with the name. This is the feeling for the name. Because now you become my lover. Before was material person was lover, and I am doing the similar with that person. Same thing happened with name today. Right or not? Understand? So any no restrictions, where is and what time we have to go? 24/7 has to go. Mahaprabhu himself not chanting in the toilet. When he goes in the toilet, he's not, the name is coming, but he is stopping to chant. Then, one time he come out from the toilet, then Gopal Guru is asking to him, "You glorify for the chanting, but I know I am trying to listen that you are chanting inside toilet. Toilet or not?" He said, "No, no, it's not to chant. Because this is not a pure place." Then Gopal Guru asked, "If somebody die in the toilet, then what will happen, Prabhu?" So Mahaprabhu himself said, "You are my guru. Your name will be Gopal Guru. You are younger than me, but you become guru." This Gopal Guru name, guru word mentioned by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. After that, he changed Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama. Because now is not Veda Mantra. You can chant any place, any time, any circumstances. And Prabhupada says, you are right, Gopal Guru. From today, you are my Guru.
And there are no strict regulations as to when to chant or remember these names. Such is your mercy. O Lord, but I'm so...
When mercy is coming, what is mercy? Something is special that you have will see. It's a feeling. You start chanting before you don't want to do, now it's happening to your life, is not mercy. You like to keep japa, you don't want to leave, you can leave your clothes, you can leave your money, but you don't want to leave your japa and you want to carry every place where you go. It's not mercy. Why you are carrying the japa bag? Leave it. You will be free for some time. No. It's not possible. Why? This is giving mercy to you. This is the reason you don't want to leave. When you are alone, when you are disturbed, and you take the japa, and then you feel relaxed. You got the all answer what to do. So slowly, when mercy you feel, you cannot start, you cannot leave that. This is mercy. You see, I surprised to see my brother Sundara. How many days he got to take the harinam, but you see his hand always with japa. I'm proud of him. This is Sukriti. Previous sanskara. Make him again immediately open. He got harinam and the sanskara bring him right back the place where he left the things. This is previous sanskara. And sometimes we listen and try to understand, we don't understand because no previous sanskara is there. We try to by force do, but nothing is happening. Because what? Koi previous sanskar is not there. No good karma in my life previous happened. So that is more influencing me to bring back to the material suffering. Are bhai, this time you develop sanskara, that will help you next life. You are not ready to complete yourself, everything in this life. After is helpful. Sanskara, what you are developing day to day, is very helpful. Not only to you, to all the family members. They will get the benefit unknowingly. Like you see, your daughter, what is her name? Sudevi.
Anasuya.
She is small baby. How old she is?
Nine.
How many rounds chanting? 12 rounds. Without any advice of father. Why chanting? Because previous sanskara is there. In previous life she do and she like to do. Why she born in the Vaishnava family? Where mother and father is devotee? She no need to eat meat and no need to preach about the vegetarianism. Morning and evening looking my grandma, my father, mother, what they are devoted. So she born in the family where the Vaishnava, the family, because of previous sanskara. She got the opulence flat because of the previous sanskara. You see the Subhara flat, opulence. No effort she got it. She not only got father, mother also sweet and kind-hearted. Previous sanskara. Vrindavan coming, positive from childhood. She comes, you see, she is so friendly with everything, nobody can say that she is from Srisgar. You see? Previous sanskara.
Grandmother also.
Grandmother also. See her sadhana. When the hard time comes in her life, his husband lose the money. And one day from so top richness, she come to zero. After that, I never see any sadness in her face. This is the one quality of devotion. Happy or distressed, normal state. Husband and wife, they are two way. Husband way is this way and wife way is this way. And that she is so adjusting with him is a surprise. Without devotion, nobody can do that. Full devotion with Radha and Krishna make her so strong that she is caring full time. Although she eat meat, anything, alcohol, but she no bother. She cares like a great soul. Never any feelings of negativeness. This is the greatness of her. I see Kundalata also. These are the qualities of devotion, my dear, that you don't become unbalanced with any opposite circumstances. You are balanced in every circumstance. Bhajan Shakti, power of bhajan. This is mercy in your life of Swami Radhika. Material thing losing is nothing. It will again come back. If my faith is fixed with the Krishna, He gives and he is testing to me. He will give himself to me. If I am so normal in his state, he will offer himself to me. You are my best devotee. I want to be with you. Everything will come back. Because Krishna nature, first we steal, and then you are normal, situated, peaceful, then he gives himself to you. And when he gives himself, that everything who he creates, everything comes back with him. This is the beauty of devotion. Go. Or the beauty of name.
O Lord, all your names have transcendental power, and there is no restriction when to chant and how to remember. But O Lord, I am so unfortunate that I have no taste for this chanting.
This is the point. Taste means feelings. Because Radhika Mercy is not there. No feelings are there. Rasa is no meaning. Rasa is not talking. Feeling is talking. This feeling, taste means feelings. What you do? Taste something. You feel something, right? The feeling is the taste. And the feeling comes by the mercy of Radhika. Taste will only come when she will give mercy of feeling to you. Then you will say, oh, I like sour only. I don't like chili. I like only sweet. I cannot eat salty. Taste is there. Why taste is there? Because I feel with sweet only. So I feel with name only. That becomes tasteful to me. Why feeling taste? Because I start living with the name. When you start living with someone, you fall in love with that. And name person is no difference. If you name and the person is the one, you and your name is the one. People know you through the name. But name, your name is you. So similarly, Krishna's name is also Krishna. It is not that name is different and Krishna is different. My Swami is different and her name is different. Are they same, bhai? You feel Radha Dasi, you will get the same. This will bring you for that. Means I will. Nami and Nam is no difference.
Sri Mahaprabhu descended with all devotional mellows.
Mellows? What is the mellow? There are only five mallow. Devotional mallow is five. Passive, active,
friendly.
Friendly.
Motherly.
Motherly. Motherly, fatherly, elderly. Yes. Like Jesus has a father. His son he makes father. How he God become father? Because first he becomes son. That I always say. If you want conjugal love, what you are the conjugal girl love? But he want to be in conjugal love. If you want to be in conjugal love, then you need some other body. But if you want to be in conjugal love with Radha and Krishna's devotion to see, then you need your spiritual body. Like Jesus make his spiritual body fixed, then he was with Father. He was not having in the his gross body, physical body. And his teaching, relation and your body, your spiritual body is important. That I like very, very, very much. And I see Jesus and do practice. What's the problem? If he believe that I am a son, is a spiritual body. And he was in mallow. Mallow is a relationship. What is your mallow? And where is your spiritual body you have? Only two things. No, forget me to believe. Forget other to believe. Believe Jesus. Do things. Everything will be crystal clear to you. But you don't believe Jesus. That's the point. Then how you will understand him? That is the missing point. You don't believe the spiritual mind. Why you will follow that? This is the nature, culture we got it. Why I will follow? Why I will believe? Why I will surrender? I will do my thing. Okay, do. Go in the fire, forest fire, and burn yourself. Who said that you don't burn? Again, you need next body to practice. But without two things, your soul is spiritual body and relation is a mallow, nothing will happen. And the lover's name, son has a lover, father. Conjugal love has also love. Conjugal relation. My son and his lover is our goal of Manjari Sarup. Then Manjari Sarup will come. If not, then why coming? No coming. My practice is to do A, I am doing C. What will happen? Nothing, zero. If it's A to do, I have to do A.
Srimad Mahaprabhu descended with all devotional mellows.
All mellow he bring. Descended, coming to this earth with all mellow.
And indicated the supremacy of Nam Sankirtan in his first verse.
Supremacy. Because it's a natural. If you in separation with your lover, that is most. Then his name and his picture is very relieving to you. If you have a picture of your lover, my boyfriend, then this boyfriend looking one time is giving so much relief that I am in meeting. Or if I have no picture, then I know the name and I remember the name and I feel separation and cry for him when I will see you again. Why you are so far from me? Why are you giving suffering? Why not you come in my front and hug me? I'm missing you. That is the name. When I miss you, then I cry for you. When I remember you, I think for you. And that becomes me. Because I'm so close and you leave me. You don't feel for me. Then I will live with your name and die with your name. Because you leave me. You have many, you went to others. But I have only you to take care. I will die for you because I have only you to think. You have many lovers, but for my, you are the one. So name becomes important. This name makes me giving hope in my life. That clearly I will see you. Yeah. Clear?
Remembering the sweetness of the name. The Lord.
Name is also become sweet like you. Your sweetness you give in your name. Your smiling, your embracing, your talking is all I feel with your name. This was the love of son with father. This was the love of friend, and this is the love of the one conjugal maidservant of Radhika for Radhika. As per your mellow, you taste the feel it. But feelings are not there. Then we no desire for that. Feeling make you to desire.
remembering the sweetness of the name, the Lord, since devotion is by nature never satiating thought. How much mercy Krishna has placed in his names. But alas, I am deprived of relishing their mellows. I do not have taste for chanting these names. The Lord's heart then became filled with humility and sorrow. And he spoke this second verse, pretending to be a struggling practitioner, although
we are struggling practice. We are struggling for mellow. We are struggling for the feelings. But still the feelings and mellow is not coming. Relation is not developing. Because I am attached with the material things so much, my mind is not coming out from that. Big engagement with that. Yeah.
The Lord's heart then became filled with humility and sorrow. And he spoke this second verse, pretending to be a struggling practitioner, although he is the Supreme Absolute Truth himself. Srila Kaviraj Goswami wrote, while humility and sorrow appeared in his heart, the Lord spoke this verse, but the sorrow and lamentations of anyone who hears it will go far away.
Very good. Again, says, you know, understand.
Krishna, Kaviraj Goswami wrote, while humility and sorrow.
Humility also, Trinadapi. My false ego, not due to understand anything.
While humility and sorrow appear in his heart, the Lord spoke this verse. But the sorrow and lamentations of anyone who hears it will go far away. This means that one will get love for the chanting of Harinam. And the misery of material existence will vanish as a mere side effect. this means that one will get love for the chanting of Harinam and the misery of material existence will vanish as a mere side effect. Another meaning of dukkha shoka is that the misery of and the lamentation over one's lack of taste for chanting will disappear. After all, this second verse describes both the great misery of the Lord as he has invested all his transcendental potencies in his holy name, as well as the fact that there is no love and taste for chanting his holy name. Therefore, we have to hear the explanation of this verse with great attention. This means that one will get love for the chanting of Harinam and the misery of material existence will vanish as a mere side effect. Another meaning of dukkha shoka is that the misery of and the lamentation over one's lack of taste for chanting will disappear. After all, the second verse describes both the great mercy of the Lord, as he has invested all his transcendental potencies in his holy name, as well as the fact that there is no love and taste for chanting this holy name. Therefore, we have to hear the explanation of this verse with great attention. According to their nature and backgrounds, people have different tastes. Therefore, it is not possible for everyone to have taste or even greed for one single name of the Lord. It is natural for the practicing devotee to have a particular taste for the name.
Wow. Everybody has a taste with different manner.
Gurudev, before Mahaprabhu there was no chanting of Harinam, but what is with Gayatri mantras?
They were chanting Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is chanting, but he avoids to chant in toilet.
Yeah, but different. Hare Rama starting. Huh?
Yeah. Veda mantra. Hmm. So he made Hare Krishna. Mahamantra is also there. And it's not giving any negative result.
But he's bringing this Manjari mood. in with his appearance. So what is with Gayatri mantras, and is he making?
Sorry.
What?
So I'm asking about Gayatri mantras chanting after Gauranga Mahaprabhu came. Did he make also some special effect in chanting of those?
You not see the special effect of Mahaprabhu? You have not feeling the special effect of chanting? Everyone is feeling. Gopal mantra and Kam Gayatri, these two mantra he received. Mahaprabhu. You will feel how much you chant, then you will see. 10 times not all. You know, maintaining that I have one guru also, this maintenance of my connection. But your realization will start coming when you chant more this one. Then Mahamantra will give you another special feeling with your marrow.
According to their nature and backgrounds, people have different tastes. Therefore, it is not possible for everyone to have taste or greed for one single name of the Lord. It is natural for the practicing devotee to have a particular taste for the name of his favorite chosen deity, his Ishvadev.
Chosen deity. That is your yoga field. The point of meditation. Your chosen deity is something and you meditate in something. What will happen? Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, they are brothers, they are living in renounce order. They are chosen devotees. Radha, Govinda, and one chosen devotee is Madan Mohan. They are doing service in chosen devotees. This is Esther. And where he sits, where is that? That is my yoga field, the place of my meditation, or my chosen devotee. Then divine yoga field will come to you. Then we have to serve.
Thank you.
what picture and photograph of yoga pit is fixed in my deity altar. That is Janita, you see?
It is natural.
This is not unnatural, it is natural. Unnatural is unnatural. And what is natural is not unnatural. It's a nature. Only I will meditate where is my lover. I will meditate, my lover is here and meditate in somewhere else, some other place. My chosen. My lover is my chosen. I choose my love. And everybody has the right to choose his lover and give his name. The lover's name, lover's beloved give to the lover's name. Nobody can say you are wrong because you have chosen lover. You choose. People will think they're progressing. Progress. Because mellow is there.
Sannyasi from Gaudiya Math give one name, is Radha Gopinath. But one day when I meditation in front of my deity, I listen the name, this deity is Radha Shyam. What do you think about? This
Radha
is only
Shyam.
Imagination?
Radha Shyam.
The name real is Radha Shyam. Is it not my imagination?
No. If this is
emanated.
So, but Sridhar Maharaj said, whole life I will dream like this. This is the truth. Radhesha.
It is natural for the practicing devotee to have a particular taste for the name of his favorite chosen deity.
Wow. Favorite and chosen. Lover. Deity is very formal. Talk, lover. Choose. Lovers can choose to love. And they know what mellow I want to be with my lover.
Therefore, the all-merciful Lord descended in innumerable forms, with innumerable names, like Krishna, Ram, Nrisimha, Vamana, etc.
Now, one person is devotee of Narasingha, and one is devotee of Rama, and one is devotee of Krishna. You can see the matter. Very different.
Different ras.
Different rasa. And we associate with different rasa. We associate normally with Narasingha devotees. We are Krishna practitioners, but we associate with Narasingha, Narayan devotees. They talk the name of Krishna, but they are giving feeling to Narasingha. Narayan feeling.
So much sweetness.
You're dropping lemon in your milk. One drop of lemon can destroy whole milk. Your feeling will die. The milk form will change. And they change. Again we put yogurt and making milk. Want to make milk, it becomes yogurt. Then again we buy the milk and begin cooking, and then again I drop one. Whole life is happening like that. Who dropping? One drop? I go for taking this drop. And life is going on and on. Because goal is not clear. My sarup is not clear. My mellow is not clear.
This Narasingha kavacha for protecting, it's better than...
Very good, very good.
I can keep this or...
Why not? How I can say? It's going to affect us.
I have
to be
feeling
there.
That it protects me.
If I will leave his protection, then where we will go? Swami will not protect us. Narasingha will protect us very safely. Why? You smile, why?
I was smiling with Shyam, who was realizing something, understanding something, looking.
You say to Jesus to change your mellow. Is are you crazy? I will never change my mellow. Because I am fixed in my sarup. You are not fixed in your sarup, you change your mellow. Because you have no mellow. But my mellow is fixed. I will not change my son. I will not become father. You make me father, but I will see the myself son. Are, this is the problem. We know fixed in our sarup that we are Radha Dasi. We are Dasi of Radhika. She kill me, she do what she like to do for me. I am ready to accept everything. am his baby and he is my everything, all my savior. Why I will think for that? But no, I don't believe this. I have to take 5 friends that if he missed to do something for me, I will use other. Like a prostitute. Females are not prostitutes, males are prostitutes. Nature of prostitute is there. Nature makes us think for 5, 10, then we become prostitutes. Then we do the parikrama. Tourist program. One tour, Braja Pachkosi Prakrama, for my goal, my east goal, happiness, and one to search the my what is to do in life. That is the tour for me. Which mellow I have to go on. That is my tool. And one is fixed, no tool. You see, Suniti? Still her tool is not finished.
Her tool?
Did she get? Why? Because mellow is not fixed. Like my Trivanga, he come to India, I know that. But his mellow is so unfixed that he was in South India, but he never think to come and think for Vrindavan, because mellow is not fixed. Right or not? Who will see this? You have to see yourself. Nobody will say you.
Apart from the main names like Krishna and Ram, the Lord has many other names according to his birth, activities, attributes and pastimes. Everyone chants these names which he likes the most and thus purifies his heart and is blessed by attaining prema, the love of God, and the service of the Lord's lotus feet.
Prema. Name give you prema. And when the prema and name is together, then everything becomes rasa purna, juicy.
The greatness of such chanting of one's favorite name is clearly described in Srimad Bhagavatam. It says, as a dedicated devotee, does sings the name of his beloved deity.
Yeah, beloved is the one. No, it's the name only. Beloved, my sweetheart, my dear darling, this beloved. This is the beloved.
His heart melts as his anurag, his sacred passion, appears and he loudly laughs, cries, sings and dances like a madman.
One point there. Then madness is coming. It's not beloved, no, not never coming. It should be beloved. You loudly sang, cry, dance only because of beloved. He's your beloved.
Become pagal.
Pagal. Everyone is pagal. But one is pagal for material things. One become power, pagal for the beloved. Lovers. Who is better pagal? This is better pagal. Many pagal is bogus pagal. Money, 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 money.
That is a need that chanting only the mantra and the name and the personal deity together.
Mantra given by Gurudev. Not your extrapolation. Why Guru is necessary? You want to become Guru? Why I follow me? Jesus said, you have to follow your spiritual master. You not try to follow yourself. Take the advice of your spiritual master and what his instruction, that to follow. If not, then material mind will make you crazy. You will not assess what is spiritual, what is material idea coming.
इसी
में सर्विस करी रहते हैं पिछले साल आपके यहाँ पे अभी हम बिजी हैं कथा चल रही है फिर मैं बेटा
I read verse again. This is beautiful. As a dedicated devotee, thus sings the name of his beloved deity. His heart melts as his anurag, his sacred passion, appears. And after that, he loudly laughs, cries, sings, and dances like a madman, not caring for the external world.
This is the love. This is the grace. This is the oneness. I become one with your feeling and my feeling become one. You think and I feel that. This is only Manjari can do. They feel what their Swami is thinking. Manjari. Oneness. One.
And this verse also shows like a process. First one sings the name of his beloved deity. And then by singing this or by doing this, his heart starts to melt. And then when the heart is melting, now the platform is there for real anurag, for real bhav to enter. And the result of this is he becomes pagal. Beautiful.
Yeah. Underline.
In his Sarartha Darshani commentary on this verse, Srila Vishwanatha Chakravarti explains that prema is infused into the heart of the devotee while he chants the name of his beloved deity. And he loses sight of his external world. Because he sees the enchanting transcendental pastimes of the Lord day and night. And he laughs and cries.
Yeah. Pastime, not philosophy. Many are interested in philosophy, not pastime. Sorry to say. That is the blockage. Your philosophy make you to block yourself, not the entire body. You are not qualified because it's a high subject. No greed is there, so you feel like that. Narayan Maharaj said, greed hidden path. That's it. Yeah.